We're really trying to pull all of these kids off of the street so that really we can have calm. We asked today that there would be absolutely no protests, as was the request of the family. And so this is not what we represent, is not what Baltimore stands for. So I'm out here today, and I have men coming from the Christian church and from the mosque to try to pull them back.
How do you put this back in the bottle now?
I think it's to bring all of these young people together to realize that we are in a code red crisis, is that I'm asking everybody to go home and to clear the streets. And tomorrow, everybody's going to meet at the church so that we can figure out, so that we don't lose focus on what it is that we're supposed to be doing.
Has this surprised you today? None of us heard about this.
It's disappointing. We're just hours out of the funeral. The family is just hours after putting their son to rest to come just a few blocks away from where we had the services. Disappointing. And I'm hoping to bring some calm and to bring our young people back into focus as to what we're really marching for.
What do you say to do that, Pastor? What do you say to bring them, bring calm?
One, this is not what the family asked for. Today of all days, the family was very clear that this was a day of sacred closure in the funeral. So for us to come out of the burial and walk into this is absolutely inexcusable. I'm asking every young person to go back home. Tomorrow night we'll have a community meeting for us to really recalibrate, because peace is the call and the order of the day.
Do you think that this is just frustration and anger, or do you think it's much more than that? What
it's frustration, anger, and it's disrespect to the family. The family was very clear. We've been saying it all along. Today, there is absolutely no protest, no demonstration that we go back into the street on tomorrow.
Pastor, what are you hearing? We're hearing it's not just in this area, but North Avenue as well, possibly downtown.
We have a team of men from the church going to North Avenue now to pull back those young people who are absolutely out of control, so that we can bring some order. This is a peaceful movement, and we plan on maintaining that
order.
There's
discussion about them moving toward downtown again.
Yes. We have a line of gentlemen from the Nation of Islam who are going to build a human wall, as well as men from the Christian church making that human wall to let the men know that they've got to send these children
where
back.
Where is that happening?
It's downtown is what I'll say.
So all across downtown, wherever.
From North Avenue to downtown, those hotspots, we're pulling everybody back so that we can have calm and order. Violence is not the answer for justice.
Pastor, you're saying this is a peaceful protest, but we've seen people, demonstrators, agitators, however you want to refer to them, throw rocks, bricks.
No, today what has happened this afternoon is not peaceful, and it does not reflect the spirit and the heart of this movement. This is a movement of peace. We're calling for justice, not for vengeance and not for violence. This does not represent the Gray family, nor does it represent the last 7 days of peaceful protests. And so we're asking all of those who are participating to go back home. Tomorrow we start afresh and anew and stay focused on justice for this family and justice for Baltimore.
Have you spoken to the mayor?
I have not spoken to the mayor.
And where do you go from here? You're getting your
Focus is not the mayor. My focus is not the police commissioner. My focus is these black children on the streets. I don't want them arrested, wounded, or tear gassed. I want them all to go back home.
Very powerful message today at the eulogy. How does what you're seeing now on the streets square with that?
It doesn't. This is a complete disconnect from what it is that we've seen the last couple of days. We've had a week of peaceful protests outside of what happened on Saturday, and we're going to go back to basics, is that we're believing no justice, no peace, but that peace has got to have balance and has got to have order. Breaking glass and windows is not reflective of justice and what it is we're calling for.
Pastor, you're on the street.